Hey there everyone, how's everyone doing? This is Nish from here, and today I am back and we are gonna be checking out what if the sun transformed into a black hole. So what is a black hole? A black hole is an area, a region of really high density of gravity. It's really dense because a lot of matter is constrained within a small point. So what happens with a black hole is that when the star is about to finish its fuel, which is hydrogen or any other fuel, so when it's about to finish, the star suddenly squeezes inside it and then suddenly explodes, and that explosion is called supernova. So after the supernova, either the star turns into a black hole or a neutron star. So a neutron star is also a really dense star, and it's really dangerous to go on a neutron star, and yeah, means you don't want to be anywhere near the neutron star. And about black hole, I'll just show you right now. So we'll just first of all make the sun explode. So we're going to be suddenly increasing the mass of sun from 1 mass of sun to 20 sun. And as you can see, this is a supernova. All its material is getting ejected outside. And this is also how we formed. Everything in us is a part of the star, as like the star contains organics, iron, silicates, water. So like you have a ring with you, a gold ring you're wearing. So you might think that we got it from digging mines, but it's not. When the star exploded, or everything was just exploding like this, and then slowly these clouds combined together to form small rocks, then rocks to planets, and then this planet like this, millions and billions of other planets. So just like that, we are formed. Now you can see the sun is also being said a supernova remnant, which is a kind of neutron star, but it is not really dense. And I'm gonna be running a new simulation to show you the sun into a black hole. We're gonna be taking stars, then sun, and we have placed it here. And if we increase its mass a lot, then it will supposedly turn into a black hole. And it exploded, and we will increase it more. Let's make it like 10 suns. Then go on. Just hang on for a second. Oh, well, I'll just instantly increase its mass on one build keep it. So now you can see the sun is transformed into a black hole. It's really black, you can't see anything inside this. Okay, and as you can see, light is bending because of gravity, and the gravity is so dense that even light cannot escape from it. So light also goes inside, and you should know that nothing is faster than light in this universe, as proved by Einstein's relativity. So this part is called the event horizon, and this is the last part. And as you go on slowly going deep and deep, everything slowly blackens out, and then you just find yourself into crushing gravity and death. So we're gonna be shooting some things, like we'll shoot a Earth launch, and okay, why are you there? Well, that might be a glitch, I suppose. It's rushing, okay. We will orbit it. Take a random number. What is this glitch? Oh, don't mind it. So, now I'll show you some properties of this black hole. So its mass is around 1 Milky Way. That's actually too much. Then its radius is around 7 lakh kilometer or 700,000 kilometers, and density around 7.96 e^11, and age is around 5.27 days as it just nearly formed. And its surface temperature is 4,000. Actually, this is the surface temperature of Sun, but it won't be. It's like 0.00000041 around these kelvins. I mean, it's really cold, as there is no light and no energy. Energy, sorry about that. And escape velocity is 1,560 light speed. So one light speed is around 3 lakh kilometers per second, or the exact is around 2,99,000. Let me just check it for a second. Okay, so it's around 2,99,792. 2,99,792. 458 meters per second. So that's a lot. And yeah, around about its materials, it would be same as that of Sun, and whatever we increase, there's nothing. And I also forgot to tell about that. At the center, there's a really small squeeze point, which is called the singularity. And the singularity has all the mass, and this is all just its effects. And to tell you that, if we want to make the Earth into a black hole, then the Earth has to be squeezed into the size of peanut. Yes, into the size of peanut. So that's it. Now we'll just to try to do some beauty parts. Okay, so yeah, that was it. And I'll show you some more black holes, like this separating this universe sandbox, like this Sagittarius A, which is the black hole of our Milky Way at the center of our galaxy. And I can see the difference between its size and the Sun Roman emanate. Oops, oops, oops. Let me slow down. So this one was the Sun over emanate, and this is the black hole which holds our whole galaxy. So you can see how small and how big is this one. I'll show you more comparisons. Let me just get a clean orbit. Okay, it's going, it's going. Great. Now we'll add another black hole, which will be 1 million suns. This one is 1 million suns. You can't even see this, can you? I'll wait for a second. Yeah, we got it. So this is even smaller, but they have got a lot of power. They can just crush you. We'll add another one, which will be 100,000, 1 million, 100 million suns. This one is also really small. No, 10,000 million suns. Small. Then 1 million million suns. So this is at least a little big. And then 10 million million suns. Oh my god, this is massive. Super massive black hole. And you know that if there is super massive black hole and you're approaching it with a really lot of velocity, then physicists say that you can go beyond the singularity and enter the fifth dimension. And that's a lot of string theory and stuff. Okay, so easy. It's -273 degrees Celsius, or 1 Kelvin, 0 Kelvin, sorry. Means it's the coldest place. Actually, the coldest place in the universe are voids, null voids, which are nearly empty. So it, that was it, and thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. This is your host, Nishuno.